Hey, hello, good afternoon. Today it's time for episode 6 from New Milestones. Here it goes. In my latest vlog, I put a promotion online. You could get 4 of my ebooks for free. I gave more than 60 ebooks away, from which 52 for A Pharaoh's Guiding. I read it again, and I think it's a very nice book. Also with some artwork inside of the book. I would like to ask the people who bought it, want to give me a star and or comment. In that way, more people might want to read my books as well. Thank you, thank you. I was in fantasy all the time. How is it possible to lose reality sense? Feelings come and go. The box of thought behind it all in madness. Your own inner feelings are gone, sucked inside a delusion. It is strange how things work. I was knocked out every day, chronic psychotic. The phases of being delusional were pretty intense. Trying to find reality in every corner of your mind and soul. Blocked off from the sunlight. First fake designs are in every corner to be found. Projecting that on everything. Gradations. Big and small boxes, drifting off the shore, searching for your own inner being, hopping from one side to another, locked up inside, not in touch with universal love. You put the fake designs up front. Many steps taken, cut off from your own inner core. That was mostly the case with everything I did. Sucked inside mazes, listening to, thinking that it is reality. The mind is a big piece and it can go into many directions. Not believing yourself anymore. Are you inside a thought? How many steps have you taken? Got lost? Like I said, many gradations. After the weekend. Spring arrived. We are a couple of days ahead from winter time. Today is the first day with higher temperatures of 16 degrees Celsius and above that. I bought some new clothing for spring and summertime. Really happy with it. Today is the first day with new light colors. A year ago, I ordered a violet and yellow shirt. It didn't look bad, so I continued the course in the same direction. New lighter colors again. I like my wardrobe. There was a time I couldn't afford new clothing, mentally unstable and not caring much about my appearance in general. Nowadays, I'm saving up money, paying all of the bills on time, and I'm debt-free, sort of. That is a great feeling indeed. In the last couple of days, I stayed home mostly. Dinner with my parents a couple of times. Painting again. I just finished the latest one, which took me at least 3 days. I put it on social media and got some likes. I also put a movie online which had 38 views on Instagram. I want to continue this week with a new canvas of the same size. Also, ordered pictures from my latest acrylic artwork. So if you're interested, you can always ask me to send them to you for a fair price. It was great to paint again. Always amazed what I create. There are so many different ways to start and continue the artwork in a certain direction. Mostly, I draw a couple of lines and or colors, and from there on, I continue. It also depends on my mental state sometimes. But I did notice that I can draw or paint always in any condition I'm in at the moment in time. I think that's very strange. My mind and feelings on the canvas. It is me in a way, and because of that, I'm painting about the afterlife mostly. I think that is a very nice subject. I can express myself in this way, in different gradations. I did make psychotic artworks as well in the past. I do like them though. In that time, I didn't. I nearly threw them away, actually. I'm always very enthusiastic in which the way the painting will go to. So many outcomes, and none of them are bad. That is really great. To be continued. I'm listening to Marilyn Manson's Mechanical Animals, an album I had back in the day when it came out. Nowadays, I don't listen to his music anymore, but back then, I did. I did like his work back then. Funny to see the musical course through time. Next is an album I listened to around the same time, which I'm still very fond of, and that is Beck's Mutations. I'm searching through my library and reminded myself that a local band called Blanco is doing really well. I would say check them out, Blanco with a K. I see the link below. Other things, I didn't watch any series except for one, and that's Solar Opposites. Really digging that new series. Great temperatures again. A nice sun shining. Helped out a friend and a neighbor. Didn't take long. I was out of the house for a bit, making a stroll as well. We'll continue painting later on again on the day. There is also a match from the Dutch team against Gibraltar. Because we lost from Turkey recently, we need to win with big numbers today. In that case, we have more points to go through to the World Championship in Qatar next year. The European Championship didn't have a go because of the coronavirus. In the other two tournaments, we didn't participate. That was pretty sour. So I hope we'll go there next year. I must say, we did became second in the Nations League. checked out my channel with some vlogs. The top vlogs I made was about the medicines I use and used in the past. More than 8,400 views, 186 likes and 3 dislikes. That was one of the being chronic psychotic and heavy schizophrenic vlogs. Vlogging about my life, trying to be as honest as possible in explaining what I've been through. Explained by poems and artwork as well. The second vlog was about the same series, but the 8th episode. More than 1,700 views, 46 likes. You can still see I'm down and out in certain vlogs. Strange to see myself in that way. The last vlog I made in the top 3 was a movie about paintings I made when being released from hospital. Dark and psychotic paintings. I do like them though. But nowadays, I make totally different art, mostly about the afterlife. And this vlog has more than 1,300 views and 116 likes. I'm trying to improve myself. Step by step, I'm doing more things. Still tired a lot and delusional sometimes. When I keep it to my boundaries, I'm feeling better. Like the 2-hour rule. In that way, I can do things and go back home when I'm feeling less stable. Then I do need my rest. Because I'm doing less things, but doing these things more often through time. Step by step. The gradations are weird and strange to encounter. Doing these things outside of the calendar, sort of. I still have trouble with following time. How big is the thought, for instance? When do you reach the shore? Or are people interacting with my thoughts that are popping up in my mind each time? How deep does time go? What is my inner core? Your own inner sound. Thoughts and feelings are passing by. But when are you in the mind? In fantasy world, so to speak. When does it feel well, blowing these thoughts up in fantasy worlds? The inner thoughts of the turmoils, in a way, swapping from one box to another. There is always a place, eventually, outside of these boxes where you will feel at ease, that people aren't interacting with your thoughts and feelings. I do think it's possible that people can feel energies from each other. You shouldn't be delusional when thinking about these things, though. Like I said, there are different gradations within thoughts and feelings. When being sucked inside these vacuums too much, perceptions do change. Everything that life has to offer is gone within the psychotic mind, from the inside to the outside, turned over and back again, locked up in madness, locked up within time, within seasons, hours of the day, losing the game. Getting out of the psychosis is a tough job. Other things in life are lost as well, like school, work, relationships, children. You can't do these things when being really psychotic. Life is fake then, interacting with the madness of the mind on the first row. I'm grateful for the people I have in my life. Good friends are better than the number of friends you have. Besides, I'm still recovering and can't do much. I don't mind that. The less things I do have to encounter, the better I feel. I still have troubles with that. Starting all over again, learning about the madness I had before, learning about God, big time. That saved my life. It can get even worse when committing suicide, you know. Other normal things, of course, are not killing people and raping people and that sort of things. Because everything will come back again in another life. Even if you don't believe in that, you can look at the afterlife. You will change massively when believing in the afterlife. You make different choices. Let me see. Another part. Oh yeah, I watched the match from the Dutch team against Gibraltar. The first half wasn't great, but the other half was. Great football, many goals. We won with 0-7. Other great news was that Turkey versus Latvia turned out in a draw, 3-3. Because of that, they each have 1 point instead of 3 points. Because of that, and because we scored so many goals, we're higher in the rank and are in the second place with only 1 point below the first place. The next couple of matches will take a while. That is in September. Today was a nice day, great temperatures and the bright sun shining. I stayed indoors most of the day, though. It was nice to be outside for a bit. I had dinner at a friend's place. Back home, I did my internet routines and put on Amy Winehouse. It has been 10 years ago since she died. And there will be coming out a new documentary about her life this year. Noticing I'm still not there yet. Delusional, mostly. It is less than in the past, though. Stuck inside my thoughts and feelings. Projecting fantasy on it and not knowing where you are. Because I'm on my own, I can't manage, I guess. When being in the surrounding of other things, I'm lost, mostly. When being in fantasy, you lose your personality in a way. What is reality? What are your goals in life? What is life about? On the long term and short term. I think I need some fresh air. Maybe going on a holiday as a first step. After the corona, of course. I do feel at ease when doing as less as possible. Adding things I love doing. The gradations are deep sometimes and difficult to cope with. Difficult to explain. Every day a small step into the future. Sometimes a step back. Within yourself, there is nothing wrong with that, only you forget about it, the inner worlds of yourself. Not much are talking about that, so you slide into a gap, projecting your inner thoughts on your surroundings or on the mind. If you need to do things all the time but don't want to, there is sort of a burnout around the corner. You become what you don't want to be. You have to be bigger than that. You think you've lost, but instead you will grow massively in the light of the highest phase of the afterlife, making good of past lives, again growing massively. Anyways, losing yourself within yourself, slipping away inside an eternity of madness, like there are multiple steps, only not in the right direction. What is life about? What is reality? Losing again, like steps on a chessboard. You do need these steps, but when being chronic psychotic, you're in fear and anxiety all the time, cut off from real life. That's pretty tough. Hallucinating and delusional all the time. Where and what is the inner core? It is pretty difficult and you're lost big time. That was about it for this week. I would say have a really great week, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.